started in service tonight, we need to be praying for Sister Joyce. She needs a miracle. Amen. She needs a miracle. Amen. It's the only thing that's going to help her. Amen. We know that God will do what is right. We know that God is in total control. We know that nothing can stop the divine will of God from being done. Amen. But oh, we need to pray. We need to believe God to just lift her up and raise her up. Amen. Church, I want you to just stretch up your hands towards heaven tonight. Father, in the name of Jesus, once again, Lord, we lift up Sister Joyce to you. Lord, unless you undertake, she won't be here too much longer. But Lord, we know that you were able to do exceeding and abundantly above all we can ask or think. Father, I ask you that you would lift her up. I ask you, Lord, that the breath of God touch that body. Enter into those lungs. In the name of Jesus, Lord, she needs you right now. Brother Charlie needs you right now. Glenda needs you now. Father, touch that vessel. You are the one that formed it. You are the one that created it. You are the one that breathed into the nostrils of man, and man became a living soul, Lord. We only live, Lord, because your breath is in us. Lord, I ask you that you would breathe upon her. Raise her up, I pray. Lord, bring a testimony out of this sickness, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we know what the doctors have said. We know what man has said. But Lord, you have the final say. Lord, we ask you that your will be done. Raise her up, Lord. In Jesus' name, Lord, we give you all the praise and all the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's just stand and let's just lift up our hands up unto the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Lord, we love you. We praise you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you are a prayer answering God. Lord God, tonight, Lord, as we worship you and as we praise you, we ask you, Lord, that your presence and your glory would fill this house once again. In the name of Jesus, Lord, touch every heart, touch every life, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we're not here tonight, Lord, out of routine, Lord, we're not here, Lord, out of religion, Lord, we've come to worship you. We've come to lift up your holy name, Lord. We give you the praise and all the glory in Jesus' name, and everybody said, amen. precious blood that was shed on Calvary's cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. At this time, I'm going to ask if Brother Wayne and Brother Seth, if they could just pass out the juice and the cracker tonight. We're going to partake of communion. Amen. Hallelujah.
Lord, we just thank you tonight for the body.
Lord, we do this in remembrance of Christ. And Lord, as often as we eat this bread, Lord, we do remember the finished work of the cross until you come, Lord. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. You can eat of the cracker that represents the bread tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah. After the same manner also, he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death until he comes. Father, once again, we thank you for sending Jesus, your only begotten Son. You didn't have to, but you did, because you loved us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe, that's it, would believe in him, should not perish but have everlasting life. Lord, we thank you for the blood that was shed on Calvary's cross. Thank you for the blood that purchased our eternal life, our forgiveness of sins. The book of Hebrews tells us that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. There's no forgiveness of sins. Blood had to be shed. And not just any blood. It had to be perfect blood. Sinless blood. No man, no woman could shed their blood. It wouldn't do any good. Wouldn't have done anything, but you knew that, Father. And you sent forth your Son, who knew no sin. Hallelujah. He became sin that knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the price you paid. And Lord, as we drink this grape juice that represents your blood, we remember your death until you come. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You can drink of the grape juice that represents the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's just lift up our hands unto the Lord tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah. presence of the Lord. So glad to have everyone with us tonight in service. Amen. Hallelujah. Old Brother Caden sitting up like a big boy. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So thankful for everyone that is here tonight. Looking forward to this study tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. I want to make a couple of announcements. Tomorrow night we were going to be having a special service over at Sister Joyce's, but she is really not feeling too well. At least before church she wasn't. So we're going to go ahead and just postpone that for now. Just do keep her in your prayers. So let's be praying for Sister Joyce. As always, let's just continue to hold her up in our prayers. And remember, Sunday morning, come expecting a wonderful time in the Lord. Amen. Of course, Sunday night, amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. God's good, isn't he? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Mary, testify, sis.
I love the Lord. I'm so thankful for the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
If it wasn't for that blood, where would you be? Amen. So thankful that he loved us that much to give his life for us, and that God our Father loved us that much to send his son to die on that cross, knowing what our Lord and Savior was going to have to go through.
That's right.
And I'm so thankful that he did, because it's only through the blood of Jesus that we are cleansed and made clean and free and delivered and set free. And I'm so thankful for that blood. And you know, I was thinking about Rahab when she hung up that scarlet rope.
Yeah.
You know, and that was her protection. And you know what? The blood of Jesus is our protection.
Yes.
The devil can't cross that bloodline. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm so thankful that we have the blood of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank God for his blood. Amen. Amen. Sister Marlene, testify.
I too am thankful for his blood. I was thinking this before him. Telling me before church about having a bloody nose that just went out of whack.
I had one today.
And I got to thinking about that. We were singing the blood that never loses its power.
Yes.
And I thought about the time when I had the surgery, they had to give me 6 pints of blood. My blood was gone. It had left. They had to give me more to keep me alive, you know, and then you come back later and you gave me a couple more, you know. But the blood of Jesus Christ
never loses
its power.
Amen.
It's always there.
Yes.
I am so thankful for that. He is my healer. He is my everything. I just love him.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Sister Beverly, testify, sister.
Yeah, you know, we learn about the blood of Jesus when we first come to him. But then as years went on, I never realized how that blood was supposed to be used on a daily basis as against a protection for us and against the devil coming and trying to destroy us and do things that are not coming. So I really understand his power in that blood.
Amen.
In every day thing.
Yes.
I absolutely come to the Lord Christ each night, and all my kids and all the people that I know, it's a good one. And in the morning, and there's been times the power of his blood, I know it was the power of his blood that kept some things straight.
Amen.
One time I went to Jack in the Box and I was reading my Bible in the corner, and this man came in and there was no one in there but me. And he started wrangling comments to me, and I ignored it, but he got closer and closer and kept saying, you know, things that were, I'm just wondering, what is he going to do? And so I said, Lord, what should I do? This is a demon. And it came to me and it came out and I said, the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin. God bless you. And you know what happened? He froze.
Mama.
His facial expression didn't move. Nothing. And I got my book, he looked around and I left.
Yeah.
And he was still standing there when I walked out. So I appreciate his blood, you know.
Yes,
it goes into a full volume of all sorts of things.
Yes.
Power. And
amen.
I appreciate it.
Amen. 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 Thank God for the blood. Amen. Amen. You know, it's the blood of Jesus that is going to keep us out of that great tribulation that is on its way. Amen. And I'm just so thankful tonight for the blood. Amen. Hallelujah. At this time, I'm going to ask Brother Joe, you want to take up the offering tonight, son? Huh? Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Appreciate all of your giving, as always. Amen. And all your faithfulness in your giving. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, we just love you. We thank you, Lord, for this time we can come to you in our giving. I ask you, Lord, that you would just bless this offering and multiply it. And Lord, I ask you, Lord, that you would just continue to meet the needs of your church. And Lord God, just continue to meet the needs of your people. Lord, we just give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, amen and amen. Hallelujah. There's a country for our people.